Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the 62nd season of the Town and Country Symphony Orchestra. I don't know how we did that because I'm only 38 years old, but here we are. This is obviously our water music concert. We hope you brought your slickers with you, okay? And we have several things and announcements to make today. The first important one that was handed to me as I came in was we have a new website. For those of you that understand Wi-Fi and all that stuff, the website is TCSO, Town and Country Symphony Orchestra, MO.org. And it says here, you can donate online. How about that? And number two, we have a new Facebook page. You can like us on Facebook at facebook.com/TCSOMO, and like us and share with your friends so we can fill up this auditorium. The next big announcement comes with the cards that you were getting out front there. For some reason, they missed the 2016 on the May concert, but I kind of figured that you all would know that it was 2016 by that time. So might want to take note of that. We have a wonderful concert for you today. As we said, it has to do with water throughout. One of the things we'll be doing is Scheherazade, which is the story of Sinbad and the sea. Not necessarily a specific story, but more just a generic story, which Rimsky-Korsakov had written. And it was part of what they called Orientalism or exoticism. So it's not necessarily the way the music was back then in those exotic lands, but that's the way they thought it should be. And so it's some beautiful stuff. We have several pieces from the water music by Handel that was written for King George I. Not the bad one, III, but the first. And that was their kind of stereo, where they put the orchestra in one barge, and the king and his friends were in the barge ahead of them, and they would play music for them as they went down the River Thames. It's good to be the king. We're going to be doing Ferdy Groffé's Mississippi Suite. He also wrote the Grand Canyon Suite. Those of you that smoke Marlboros know that one quite well. But he also wrote the Mississippi Suite, which was orchestrated by Paul Whiteman, who also did George Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. So there's a big Hollywood connection in there, a New York connection. And plus, all of us being that close to the Mississippi understand all of the ramifications of the different areas of the Mississippi. We're also going to have the Carnival of Venice, played by Dr. Dan Littles, who does a wonderful job. Carnival of Venice is based on the German Mein Gott, Der Hot, Dried something. In English, it comes out, my hat, it has three corners. And if you think about that, it's my hat, it has three corners. And that's the main theme of the Carnival of Venice, okay? So, very exciting. Well, another little bit of exciting news right now. I'm about to introduce our new concertmaster, who was the former concertmaster of the University City Orchestra, and we're just delighted to have him with us, Mr. Carl Hoff.
Thank you. Thank you. As you can tell, everything was given away by John when he walked out in his life vest. This concert was designed and planned last spring when we were having rain every day. And actually, the rain continued up until the last week of August, and with very little abatement. So we had rain at least every other day, if not every third day, and sometimes every day of the week. I know, because I didn't get to play much golf. But the truth of the matter is, as I was planning the program and looking at all the pieces that deal with water, one of my favorite ones to come to mind was the next piece on our program. The Carnival of Venice is perhaps one of our most well-known tunes in America, and we're very fortunate to have Dan Littles to play the cornet on this piece, because nothing is more water-oriented than Venice. If you've ever been there, and I've not been there, but it's on my bucket list, I want to go and see the canals in St. Mark's Cathedral, and also I'll have visions of this orchestra playing Carnival of Venice with Dan Littles. I'm certain that most of you are far beyond me in terms of technical expertise at this point. Today, kids walk around not with iPods, but with mixes that coming from outer space somewhere onto earplugs. And of course, not too long ago, it used to be the guys were carrying big boom boxes down the street, you know, look at me. And before that, I guess it was the transistor radio when I was a kid. I wanted to have one so bad it was about $7.50, and I didn't have $7.50 to listen to KXOK all day long. So obviously I went a different route. And prior to that, going back several years to George Frederick Handel and King George I, who was his boss in Germany, and Handel escaped or fled or asked leave of, escaped for better economic possibilities in England. It turns out that George I, who was the Elector of Hanover, succeeded Queen Anne and became King of England. And in order to get back in good graces, Handel is purportedly reported to have created this piece called The Water Music. And this is Handel's mix of different tunes, bits and pieces, which he created so that as the king would float down the river past the castle, he would be able to have his boombox, iPod, whatever, on barges behind him to accompany the pleasant journey. So we're going to start with number 10. We're not going to do the whole mix, which is listed in your program, but we're going to do 10 through 20. And when I stop, you'll know it, because everything breaks loose in the back and, you know, all the bells and whistles go off.
Thank you.
Wasn't Dan Littles wonderful? Wow. Now, you'll notice in your program there is an envelope. And as we like to say, this envelope will accept any size check you'd like to put in there. Okay? And we've decided today that anybody who puts a $5,000 check in there can take Dan Littles home. He's not cheap. So, it takes a lot of money to keep an orchestra like this going, as you all are well aware. A piece of music like Scheherazade can't be bought. It has to be rented, and that could cost upwards of $100 just to play it once. Okay? Some of the music that we buy, like the Handel, they can cost anywhere from $60 to $80, but you don't get to play it but every 5 or 6 or 7 years. So it does take a lot of money to keep going. We'd like to thank Principia once again for the use of this wonderful theater. They've done a good job. We thank them. Yes, you may applaud. A very special thanks to the music department that allows us to use their equipment, their stage, and their music room. Every week they've got to straighten it up when we mess it up. So a great big thanks to them. Now we're going to do the special part of the program where we give out our CDs. And if you filled out your name and on one of these cards here and put it in here, we're going to choose four of them today and see who wins. So a drum roll, please. I meant a snare drum, but that's all right. Our first one goes to Bob Evans. Where are you, Bob? Where are you? Raise your hand. You see him? There he is. Okay. Can I have some sausages, please? All right, never mind. Our second CD goes to... She's throwing them at me. Gonna faint from tension. Emma Benge. Where are you, Emma? Right over here. Did I say it right? Benge? Bengi. That's your sister? Well, that's a fix, isn't it? Gosh. Okay, our third one goes to Steve Gannon. Where are you, Steve? Raise your hand and wait. There he is up there, Steve Gannon. What a great name. Sounds like a private eye on television, doesn't it? The Adventures of Steve Gannon. I like it. And we have one more CD. This one goes to Marcia Oberdorfer. Where are you, Marcia? Marcia Oberdorfer. There she is. Okay. Marcia, you need a shorter name. I'm like, how many syllables in this? Okay. So right over here is Marcia. Where's our other CD at? He's running. That's why we take a younger fellow to do that. Well, once again, we thank you all for being here. If you're on our mailing list, I don't think we need to get you on there twice, but make sure that we have your email address and any pertinent information so we can contact you and let you know about all of our concerts. And we appreciate you folks. You just wouldn't believe it, because like I like to say, without you, this just be a rehearsal. Okay? So we thank you all once again for being here and for opening our 62nd season. And now I reintroduce our conductor and our concertmaster, Carl Hoff and David Peake.